And good morning, everybody. And we'll begin by singing, I am the bread of life. I am the bread of life. He who come to me shall not hunger, and he who believes in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. Hey, good morning once again, everybody. Oh, the storms were pretty fierce yesterday, with the wind blowing and the rain just coming down the sheets.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, forget not the souls of your poor ones. Lord, forget not the souls of your poor ones. Why, O God, have you cast us off forever? Why does your anger smolder against the sheep of your pasture? Remember your flock which you built up of old, the tribe you redeemed as your inheritance, Mount Zion, where you took up your abode. Lord, forget not the souls of your poor ones. Turn your steps toward the utter ruins, toward all the damage the enemy has done in the sanctuary. Your foes roar triumphantly in your shrine. They have set up tokens of victory. They are like men coming with axes to a club of trees. Lord, forget not the souls of your poor ones. With chisel and hammer, they had all the paneling of the sanctuary. They set your sanctuary on fire, the place where your name abides and is raised and profane. Lord, forget not the souls of your poor ones. Look to your covenant, for the hiding places in the land and the plains are full of violence. May the humble not retire in confusion. May the afflicted and poor praise your name. Forget not the souls of your poor ones. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Christ took away our infirmities and bore our diseases. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus entered Capernaum, a centurion approached him and appealed to him, saying, Lord, my servant is lying at home paralyzed, suffering and dreadfully. He said to him, I will come cure him. The centurion said in reply, Lord, I am not worthy to have you enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I am to a man subject to authority, with soldiers subject to me. And I say to one, go, and he goes. And to another, come, and he comes. And to my slave, do this. And he does it. When Jesus heard this, he was amazed and said to those following him, Amen, I say to you, in no one in Jerusalem have I found such faith. I say to you, men will come from the east and west and will recline with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, banquet of the kingdom of heaven, but the children of the kingdom will be driven out into the outer darkness where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. And Jesus said to the centurion, you may go, as you have believed, let it be done for you. And at that very moment, his servant was healed. And Jesus entered the house of Peter and saw his mother-in-law lying in bed with a fever. He touched her hand. The fever left her, and she rose and waited on them. When it was evening, they brought in men who were possessed by demons, and he drove out the spirits by the word and cured all the sick to fulfill what had been said through the prophet Isaiah. He took away our infirmities. He bore our diseases. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yesterday in our first represents the only hope for the people of Israel. And then, today, in the gospel reading, we have now Rome has taken over Jerusalem. And it is there in this situation now that Rome is an occupying force in Jerusalem. And in this, we have a Roman military leader, a centurion, approaching Jesus and asking that he may heal a servant of his. Now, if you can kind of imagine, okay, here people disdain the Romans. The people, because they are the occupying force, here is Jesus not only listening to a Roman military leader, but even curing his sick servant. And imagine the destruction that must have caused with the people. And we see how Jesus then continues to heal the people throughout the day. The house of Peter. And Peter's mother-in-law lying in bed with a fever. And Jesus also cured her. So that we have Jesus coming to the rescue of his people and healing them. And we too, maybe sometimes we can identify with the lamentations that was read today and what is going on in our world, what is going on in our cities, and what is going on maybe in our own lives, that we lament, and that our prayer too is like the psalmist, Lord, forget not the souls of your poor ones. Forget not the souls of your people. We pour out our hearts in the presence of the Lord as we offer our prayers today, that the church may grow in number, holiness, and faith through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord. That those in authority may be led by the word of God and the use of their power. Let us pray to the Lord. That all our ill and infirm suffering from any poverty or deprivation may receive the healing power of Christ and the consolation of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us gathered here today may grow in peace and love of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died, may they enjoy eternal rest in Christ's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the poor souls in purgatory, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for Alice Vitovsky, who remembered in a special way at this Mass, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And now I'll close with the pandemic prayer of St. Robert. Lord Jesus, hear our pleas, our good shepherd and divine physician. We implore your mercy to awake an outbreak of serious illness and disease. Guide our efforts to prevent mutation and make preparations to care for those most vulnerable. Assist all professionals and volunteers who work to eradicate the epidemic now spreading. May our actions be marked by your steadfast love and selfless service and never by panic or fear. Bestow your comfort and healing to the sick. Sustain and strengthen them by your grace. May they know your closeness as they carry the cross of illness. And may all you have called for this life come to worship you eternally with all the saints as you grant consolation and peace to their mourners. Holy Mary, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph, hope of the sick. prayers. Saint Paul, protector against epidemics, prayers. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth is given and human hands have made, to become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
be God forever. Through the mystery of this water and wine, we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed
be God forever. The Lord was made my iniquities. Cleanse me from my sins. And pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice to yours. May we be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept
the sacrifice of your hands.
For the grace of
the praise of the Lord Jesus.
For our good and
for
our
good. Look with faith, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon the sacred altar on the feast of Saint Cyril of Alexandria. That bestowed on us your pardon, our oblations to give honor to your name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, and we Father. Almighty and eternal God, bless the Lord. For on the festival of St. Cyril of the Thonies, of St. Cyril of Alexandria, you bid your church rejoice. So too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, in the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we have planned. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are redeemed, O Lord, the fountain of all things. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time of his betrayal, and after removing me into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for men, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, that we will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, the church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and his auxiliary bishops and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters asleep in the hope of resurrection. And all of thy hearers, welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Catherine of Alexandria, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through and with and in you, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy
kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours in forever. Jesus Christ, who said to the apostle, peace I leave you, peace I leave you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of Christ. I will raise you up, and I will